20 lives. Bet you doesn't even mention that we put out the blaze before they even got there.
Some of us aren't in this for the glory, Mitch.
That's the soot, right?
Yeah, right.
There's something up ahead in the water, about 2 o'clock. Hang on. It's a dog.
Take the wheel, Brooke. Get me close.
Right about 2.
Tag on the collar. Must have fallen off the boat.
But 10 miles out. There's no boats out here.
It's amazing he's still alive.
He won't be for long. Hypothermia setting in. Come on, get us back to headquarters.
Okay. You object to your girlfriend flirting with other guys. Never, sometimes, always.
Sometimes.
Sometimes.
Most of the time. Fine, always, always.
Okay. See.
You and your girlfriend cry at the same movie. Never, sometimes, always.
Brain's just stuff. It's obviously not a man.
What?
Sometimes.
Eddie, you have never once cried at a movie with me.
Fine. Never.
Okay. You are the one who plans the dates. Never, sometimes, always.
Me get to plan one of our dates? Never.
Come on, Eddie. You just got us tickets to go to the ball game last week.
Which we gave to Mitch and Hobie because we had the charity benefit. My answer remains never.
You're still mad about that, aren't you? I knew it. You're still mad.
Shawnee, we always do what you want.
We always have fun, Eddie.
Oh, fun. Right. Let's see. Charity benefits. Ooh, hey, how about those little teeny-weeny binoculars at the opera? Oh, hey, let's not forget the 7 different knives and spoons at dinner time, huh?
I guess we have real different ideas about what's fun. I guess we have real different ideas about a lot of things.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means we just scored a 10 on the compatibility test.
10? 10 could be good.
Not when it's out of 100.
Oh. Well, so what? Who cares what some stupid test says anyway?
Eddie, this test is not the point. The point is that we have so many differences. You obviously have a lot of resentment about the things that I like for us to do together. That's the point. I just feel like we're so different, you know? Maybe we need to...
What?
Maybe we just need some space.
Oh, come on. Hey.
Hey, pal. You hungry? Easy, easy, easy. Take it easy.
How's our patient doing?
Well, he's definitely off the critical list and taking nourishment.
We've checked the pounds, shelters, no missing dog fitting his description. You sweet thing, don't worry. We'll find your owner.
We could take his picture, Xerox some flyers, and distribute it through the marina. Still got your camera with you?
Yeah, it's in my locker. I'll go get it.
Great.
What are we gonna do with him until we find his owner, Mitch?
I don't know, but he's a good-looking dog, isn't he? Come here, pal.
Maybe I'll just, maybe I'll just take him home with me. Maybe he'll take me home here.
Gracie, don't ever give George a compatibility test, huh? It's Eddie. How you doing, Nicole? Number 1007.
Hi, Eddie. How's my favorite lifeguard doing today?
Well, let's just say it's nice to hear a friendly voice.
You sound a little tense.
I've had better days. So what do you got for me?
Mitch called. He wants you to work Tower 18 today.
Oh, yeah? What shift?
2 to 7. I wish I worked at the beach. I'd love to be there at sunset. It sounds so sexy. The sunlight off the waves, cool breeze. Enjoy it, Eddie. Bye.
Bye.
Do me a favor, will you? Watch him. I gotta check the tower signals.
Where'd he come from? Hey, what are you doing? Can you sit? Huh? Hey, it's a good trick.
Hey, Eddie, can we talk? Please stop ignoring me. You're really being unreasonable.
I'm being unreasonable. Well, why don't you just add that to the list?
Shoney, I'll wait for you outside, okay? Eddie, it's been real good to meet you.
Yeah.
I think I'm gonna like it here.
Well, I gotta go.
Oh, yeah, yeah. You wouldn't want to keep Derek waiting. You know, two can play that game. Isn't that right, bud? Hey. Watch yourself, huh?
Answer me. Nicole speaking. How can I help you?
Hey, Nicole. It's...
Eddie. Hi.
Hi. Got any messages?
Nothing so far.
Listen, Nicole, I'm working Tower 18. From 2 to 7?
I know. There's supposed to be a beautiful sunset tonight.
Why don't you come down and watch it with me?
It's amazing. How'd you do that?
Gotta let them know you mean business.
Let's go!
Here you go. Listen, if you recognize this dog or its owner, would you please call Baywatch headquarters and let us know? Number's at the bottom of the page. Okay? Thank you very much.
Bye. Tower 19.
Shawnee, Eddie, just want to let you know I won't be going back to headquarters tonight.
Why not?
Got plans.
With who?
Doesn't matter. See you later.
Hi, Eddie.
Thank you.
came down a little early. I hope you don't mind.
Not at all.
Okay, great. I'll set everything up.
Well, actually, Nicole, I'm starving, and I was really kind of hoping maybe we can go out and get something to eat.
But, Eddie, the sunset. Of course, there's always candlelight.
That's right.
Hey, Eddie. You have a good time.
I've got to close up my tower and change.
Oh, okay. You want me to go down there?
That would be great.
Okay, yeah. Go ahead.
I'll hustle it up.
Okay, I'll see you in a bit.
Okay.
Someone I want you to meet.
Dad! Dad, a dog! Where'd you get him?
Mia Butte. I rescued him off San Pedro this morning. We're gonna take care of him until we can find his owners.
You rescued him? That means you're responsible.
Responsible to find his owner, that's all.
Can't we keep him?
Hopester, I know how much you love a dog, but he's not ours.
But he's such a great dog.
And I know somebody misses him very much. Look, I don't want you to get too attached here, because when he leaves, you're gonna get real upset.
I won't. Come on, boy.
Oh, sand everywhere.
Hey, Dad, I'm gonna name him Sandy.
Oh, great.
So, Eddie, what's good here?
Oh, everything. Everything is good. It's everything's real good.
I've embarrassed you, haven't I?
No, Nicole.
Eddie, you don't have to say anything. I know I embarrassed you on the beach today in front of your friends. And I'm embarrassing you right now. You've never been to this restaurant before, have you?
No. No, Nicole, I haven't. But you didn't embarrass me. I embarrassed me.
Eddie, I owe you an apology. I shouldn't have just shown up at your tower like that without telling you.
No, Nicole. You don't have to apologize for anything.
I just wanted to meet you so much. And I'm ashamed of the way I look. That's why I got the job at the answering service. So no one could see me. I could pretend to be thin. Pretend that food wasn't the only thing I had to come home to. So, if you want to leave, I'll understand.
Leave? Hell no, I don't want to leave. We're staying. You and I are going to initiate this restaurant together.
Really? Are you sure?
Absolutely. Have you ever known me to lie?
Nah.
Garcon.
Was discovered that the prisoners had escaped from Terminal Island early this morning and are still at large. While not thought to be armed, they are dangerous. And in other news, the L.A. County Fire Department heroically extinguished an out-of-control fire on a yacht anchored just outside Catalina Harbor earlier today. All aboard were saved with only minor injuries.
And
now, with sports,
you,
here's our own Arthur Kimball.
I knew it!
Sandy, wait!
Hey! Down. He's filthy. What are you doing here, huh?
I'm sorry, Daddy. He got away from me and got in the mud.
Get him outside and get him cleaned up. And will you get cleaned up, too? You gotta be at Timmy's in a half an hour. Kelly's on her way over. I'm trying to have a nice, quiet dinner, if you get my drift.
Sure do, Dad.
Thank you. Don't tell me. This can't be. This can't. Oh, it is. Hey!
Hi. I'm not early, am I?
No. God, you look great. Oh, watch out. I got a little mess here.
Hi, Hobie.
Hi, Kelly. So,
oh, who's this?
My dad rescued him out of the ocean.
Oh. Oh, nice to meet you, fella. He's cute.
Remember, I'm spending the night at Timmy's.
Yes, I remember.
Bye, Kelly.
Bye.
See you later, Dad. Oh, have a nice time, guys.
Get out of here. It's a nice kid, huh?
No, Nicole, you have a lot of wonderful qualities that have absolutely nothing to do with your weight.
Oh, yeah, name one. Or 10.
Your sense of humor. And let's not forget the way you help your clients with all those crazy messages. And you have a very sexy laugh.
But look at me.
I am. And what I see is a beautiful person who has a lot to offer. Nicole's a lot easier to fix the outside than it is the inside.
Eddie, I've been thinking about losing some weight.
You can do it, Nicole. If you want to. It's up to you. But you can only lose it for you, nobody else. But I know you can do it. The power is in here. I know you can.
Cheers. I think the meat's a little overdone. I'm sorry.
Oh, no, the dinner's great, Mitch. But Sandy doesn't sound too happy. Why does he have to be in the laundry room?
Are you kidding? Laundry room's his favorite room. You know, it's warm, cozy. It's nice in there. He likes it in there.
Maybe he's hungry.
You're right. I'll be right back, okay? Perfect.
I hear you, sweetheart. Yes.
Sandy, if I give you this juicy bone, will you just can it? I'm trying to have a quiet dinner here. Shh, shh. Mmm, good. Mm. You're right, he was hungry. Okay. I would like to make a toast.
Okay.
To you, to us, to our night.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Maybe he's lonely.
Oh, come here. Come on, good boy. Yeah, come on. Oh, the good boy. See, Mitch, he was just lonely. Hi, good boy. He's affectionate, too.
Yes, I think he's had enough company for tonight, don't you? He looks awfully tired to me. Oh, he was in the ocean all day swimming. I had to rescue him. Come on, let's get some sleep. I'll be right back. Listen, Sandy, I saved your life, man, and you're not showing any gratitude. Just keep a low profile, please. Please. What? Where are you going?
Sandy's lonely, Mitch. He needs you more than I do.
He's lonely? He's not even my dog.
Mitch, you're distracted.
I'm not. I'm really not.
Spend some time with him. He must really miss his master. We'll have other nights.
Tomorrow night?
My place, 8 o'clock. Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Thanks a lot. Dog, Alpo breath.
Oh. Oh, man.
man.
Shut up!
Two o'clock. It's a beautiful thing. That's 2 hours you've been barking. I gave you pizza. I gave you rice cakes. You haven't even touched your raisin cookies. What more do you want from me? I wish you could tell me what happened, but you can't. I know you miss your master, Sandy. And I know your name's not Sandy. I'm telling you, we'll get you home. Lifeguards are really good at finding lost kids. We lose them all the time, but we find them. I promise you, we'll get you to your master. But right now, I need some sleep. Okay? Sleep.
Him. I should have let him drown.
What is it? What do you want? What is the story? I swear, if I hadn't just saved your life, I'd swear you're trying to piss me off.
Sandy. Oh, no.
Oh, no!
I'm sure hoping you can explain this.
I don't lie awake at night.
You're gonna be okay, okay? I'm taking you back to headquarters. Eddie, listen, Derek will watch your tire while I'm gone, okay?
Nicole. Listen, Johnny's gonna take care of you, okay? I can't leave my tower, but she's gonna take real good care of you. All right, I'll check on you later. All right, everybody, break it up. Break it up here.
All right. See you, Ron.
I'll check on you later. Did you see that?
This is the famous sea dog I've heard so much about. Sir, fill it, your picture doesn't do you justice.
Justice? Real justice would be a trip to the pound.
Well, what's the matter, Mitch? Haven't you and Sandy been hitting it off? You look exhausted.
Let's just say I woke up on the wrong side of the dryer this morning. Look, do me a favor, will you? Take him for the day, just for the day. I'll owe you one, okay?
Oh, okay, maybe somebody will recognize him. Poor Mitch, he doesn't know how to handle a house guest, does he, right, boy? Well, you and I are gonna have a great time, so how about a walk on the beach, huh? Sandy, here. Sandy! Sandy, get back here! Sandy, I am through messing with you. Now, I'm going to give you 1 minute personal time by the tree over there, but don't you go anywhere.
Your mouth's dry and you're weak. You say you almost fainted after the first wave hit you.
You taking diet pills, Nicole? Have you eaten anything today?
Just sand and salt water.
Hey, this isn't a joke. By taking those diet pills and laying out in the sun with no food in your system, you could have been really seriously hurt.
Seriously hurt? I've spent my entire life being seriously hurt. Hurt by jokes at my expense. You heard them out there. I've always hated girls like you. Thin and beautiful, everything coming so easy. Cheerleading and dates. Clothes that fit. I can't tell you how many crash diets I've tried. How many times I've lost 20 pounds. Only to gain 30 back. A person can be called lard butt only so many times without. Do you know what class I dreaded all during school, Shawnee? Not history. Or biology or algebra. Gym class. Pulling on those shorts for everyone to see and laugh at. You know what I realize now, Shawnee? It's not even the girls like you that I hate. It's me. I hate myself.
I can relate to that self-hatred, Nicole. And you're right. I was a cheerleader in high school. And I had great clothes and lots of dates. Lots of dates. But you know what? I never knew if those guys liked me for me, for who they thought that I was because of the way I looked. It was as if it didn't matter that I had a heart and feelings and a brain. Didn't matter at all. Because they never asked me my opinion. And if I gave it anyway, they never listened. And that hurt. They didn't bother to look deeper into me. And I guess for a while I quit looking too. And I did a lot of things that I am not proud of, Nicole. And I hated myself. But then I met someone who believed in me. In me, for who I am on the inside. And he helped me believe in myself. And Nicole, liking who you are on the inside is everything.
Is that person Eddie?
Yeah.
He's a really terrific guy. I've never felt so liked, so much acceptance in my entire life. He's a hunk. He is. But what he's got on the inside, you could never touch.
He's my best friend.
He's mine too.
Trace the boat they took off on. It belongs to a Tilly McKay. She hasn't been seen in 3 days.
Where are they headed?
They headed south. We're going to have to move to catch them.
Come on, Sandy. Come on. Yeah. All right, I got it. Let's go. Hit it.
Can, huh? Ow. right, Mitch?
Yeah.
Now, here's a man who definitely has a right to remain silent.
Good boy.
Good boy.
Where are you going?
Henry.
So that's your name, Henry.
I'm going to fix you a special dinner for saving Henry and me.
Well, actually, I would love to stay, but I really can't. You see, I got a date.
Oh, we wouldn't hear of it. We ain't had such a fine-looking young man in our boat in a month of Sundays.
Maybe some other time, huh?
No, I'm going to fix you some whiskey stew. It sticks to the ribs, boy.
Well, actually, I'd love to stay.
Yeah, well, I'll start some.
George, nice clean tank, and Gracie, I hope you approve of the new decor. Hi.
Can I come in?
Yeah, sure.
Eddie, I'm really sorry. I hope you can forgive me. I've been doing a lot of thinking. And you're right. I have been monopolizing our time with my plans. But I brought a peace offering. Dodger tickets right behind the dugout tonight.
You gotta be kidding me. See, honey, these things are impossible to get. Wait a minute, it's Saturday night. What about your parents, the club?
I told my parents that I have something far more important to do with somebody very important to me. I missed you so much.
I missed you too. Would you mind if we got there a little late?
No. Would you mind if we left a little early?
Why would we leave a little early if we're gonna get there late?
For the same reason that we're going to get there late.
Say goodnight, Gracie.